have so deep relationships with each other, because it takes work for all of that as well. This purpose, if at all they don't do things on their everyday basis to reach that goalpost, I've seen a lot of people judge other people. If you're happy being a freedom seeker all your life, wonderful.
आप अपने आप पे ध्यान ही नहीं दे पा रहे हो because we don't have time, because of the lives that we are living in. What are the type of thoughts that you have? You know, do you feel fulfilled? Do you feel like, you know, I've achieved everything? We are easily able to connect with anybody who we want. Like suddenly, I keep questioning myself. Make it work the way you want to make it work. Everything in this universe is energy.
Hey guys, welcome back to the podcast Beyond the Pain, your journey to self-transformation. Today, I am going to dive deep into a question which I think a lot of us at some point in our life ponder upon, which is having a life purpose mandatory at all in life? So I am going to shed light on my views on this particular topic. If you're interested in that, do keep watching. Also, if you want to join the conversation, do keep watching and comment your feedback in the video down below. So let's get started. First of all, what is a life purpose? Life purpose is like goalpost that we set for our life. Like, that is the mission that we have got for our life, and we have to reach that. Basically, it's something that makes us want to wake up in the morning and follow that life purpose, right? It doesn't have to be necessarily be associated to like a career or money, because a lot of times many people when say that this person has a life purpose, a lot of times people associate it to like being in a particular position in their career or earning XYZ amount of money in their life. It doesn't have to be that. It could be things like, you know, as profound as raising a child to be a kind human being. That could be someone's life purpose. Someone's life purpose could be having a healthy family wherein, you know, you have so deep relationships with each other, because it takes work for all of that as well, which basically a lot of people need. But that could be somebody's life purpose, having a beautiful family, raising very good kids. Someone's life purpose could be associated to sharing their knowledge with someone out there. Like, for example, that's what I am doing at the moment, and a lot of other creators are doing as well. Someone's life purpose could be related to a career, like they want to reach on the top hierarchy of a particular company. Someone's life purpose could be just helping others. Like, I have recently, just yesterday, I followed one person on Instagram, and his videos, oh my God, so emotional. Like, he's there on the streets of I don't know which state is it, but in India, he's there on streets and helping people, giving them money because he has been blessed with that abundance. So his life purpose is kindness and spreading that love out in the world. So life purpose in general could vary to a lot of degree. There is no one standard definition of what a life purpose is. It could be anything, any mission that person sets for themselves in this lifetime to achieve that. Okay, so that is what a life's purpose is. Now let's look at the different perspectives of this life purpose, because I think exploring those different perspectives will help us understand whether it is mandatory for us to have one, or is it okay if we don't have one. So one perspective of it is one type of people who are very purpose driven. We could call them purpose advocates. Like, these folks, they have a life purpose, definite life purpose. Like, they probably have put it out there somewhere that this is my life purpose and I want to fulfill this and go behind this to lead a fulfilling life. So their association to leading a fulfilling life is directly related to this purpose. If at all they don't do things on their everyday basis which are linked with the life purpose, they will not feel motivated. They will feel sad about it, because they are called as purpose advocates. They really, really believe to the core that having one goal in life, having one purpose in life is a very, very important thing. So they will basically argue that, you know, that's what motivates them. That is the life direction they're going after, because it's like taking an analogy of a GPS. If at all you are going from one place to another and you know which place do you want to go to, and you follow a particular direction given on the map to reach that particular destination. So they are the ones, these purpose advocates are the one who have that location in mind on where they want to reach, and they are doing a lot of things on everyday basis, on a timely basis, let's just say that. They are doing everything to reach that goalpost, to reach that purpose of life. They believe from within that they have been sent on this planet who do that particular thing. So they are the advocates for it. And in some cases, some people, I've seen a lot of people judge other people who don't have a purpose in life. So I don't think, I definitely don't encourage that. That's not a good thing. But there are a lot of purpose advocates who will judge other people who do not have purpose, while some purpose advocates, they will be like, okay, I don't care about what others think. But for me, having that purpose in life, having that goal in life is really, really important. And I'm going to go after that no matter what, right? So that purpose in their life is what keeps them so motivated and focused in their life. That builds resilience into them, because in their case, in purpose advocates' case, we are trying to reach a destination, and we all know whenever we are chasing a goal, it's not going to be a straight road. It's going to be curvy as hell. You are going to face a lot of challenges. And since these people are purpose advocates, they have that goal in mind. They will build resilience along the way, and they will reach that destination no matter what. So this is the one type of person out there who's the purpose advocates. And I just wanted to really put that out there, that there are a lot of people who are in this boat. So our perspective, suppose if I am not purpose driven, I want myself and someone else who's not purpose driven, I want you to know that there are a lot of people who are purpose advocates. Like they live their life just because they think they have a purpose in their life. Now, a different angle to look at, a different perspective to look at, is second type of people who necessarily don't have a purpose in their life. I would call them like freedom seekers. So these people, they don't have a goal post. In that map analogy, they are just enjoying the life as it comes. They necessarily are not chasing a goal in their life. In that map analogy, there is no direction they have put. They just sat in a car and they are saying, let's just go somewhere, it's going to be fun. Similar in a life situation, they just take each day as it comes. They necessarily do not think a lot about setting goals and all of that. They don't necessarily think about having one purpose in their life. They are just enjoying their life. They are enjoying their freedom. They think that I don't want to tie myself to a purpose, because that's limiting their freedom, that's limiting their creativity, that's limiting them to enjoy a life. So these type of people, I've seen a lot of this category as well. These type of people who are freedom seekers, they think that I will not be able to enjoy life and live life if I tie myself to a particular purpose or to a particular goal. So this is like a second bucket or second type of people that exist in the world. So they basically argue that you will not enjoy life if you tie yourself to one particular goal, because life is not about that. Life is about uncertainty. So if you go online and read a lot of quotes online and the type of information that people put out there, from reading what they put out there, you should be able to see which category are they falling in. Are they like purpose advocates or are they freedom seekers? None of them is wrong. It's just that people are built in a different way. So they basically find fulfillment in diverse experiences within their life. Every day, having that one cup of tea brings them so much joy. Having to just sleep for hours and watch Netflix brings them joy. Whereas in purpose advocates' case, same scenario could be like, I'm wasting time on Netflix, I'm wasting time sleeping, I want to wake up and do something. So a same scenario when given to each of these people could be presented in a different way, because their DNA is different, because they are built in a different way. Their definition of life, their definition of happiness, contentment, joy is very, very different. Purpose advocates find joy and contentment in doing something, in completing a particular task, in reaching closer to the goals. Whereas freedom seekers, on the other hand, they find joy and fulfillment in doing all the small things, and they think that since life is so uncertain, I'm just going to enjoy it. Yes, I am open to challenges as and when they come, but I don't want to tie myself to a particular goal. However, I'm living at the moment, I'm happy, I'm earning, I'm able to pay my bills, I am with a beautiful family, it's enough for me, I don't want more. So these are the two type of people that exist out there. Now, there have been psychologists who have studied these type of behavior, and the research suggests that people who are purpose advocates, people who have a goal in their life, those people tend to have better mental and physical health. That's what the research says. In my opinion, the reason why that happens is because when you are goal driven, when you have a purpose in life, you know that, like, it's like you have a anchor in your life and you're following that. Whenever there are less uncertainties, I would just plainly put it like that. For purpose advocates, there are less uncertainties in life. I'm not talking about challenges. There will be a lot of challenges, but uncertainties will be less, which means that in case of an uncertainty wherein they don't know what to do, they would always go back to the purpose of their life and they will take their decisions based on that purpose of their life and hence be able to come out of that easily. Whereas in case of freedom seekers, there are a lot of uncertainties. They don't know what they are doing. They are just doing it. And in cases wherein they are faced with uncertainties in life, oh, what do I do? What do I do? They have no baseline to make a decision on, right? So in that case, they might feel more stressed. Oh, what do I do? Maybe for a shorter amount of time, that uncertainty is there and those questions arise in their mind. Oh, what am I doing? Why am I doing? And then after that, tomorrow when they wake up, it will all be gone. But during that period, maybe it could be one day, it could be 1 month, it could be a couple of years, who knows? But during that period when there are uncertainties, they have no anchor to link to. So their mental health could be a little bit affected when there are uncertainties in life. Uncertainties will arise in both cases because we cannot predict future and we don't know what will happen tomorrow. In case of a person who's purpose driven and who has a life goal, they are following that life goal. So they are just going to ask a simple question. It might be more complicated than that, but they are going to ask a simple question that, does this situation align with my goal? Yes, then they will find a way to navigate it. No, I don't want to spend my energy on it. They will basically divert from that track altogether. In case of a person who's a freedom seeker, when some uncertainty arises and they have to make decisions on what is really happening, maybe some people have started questioning them and they don't know how to deal with it. In that case, they are just going to make guesses and they might be more stressed. So that's my way of interpreting how having a goal in life could impact your mental and physical health. Now, health in general, because I think if your mental health is affected, your physical is affected, and vice versa is true as well. So both go hand in hand. Your health in general, I think that's how I would correlate it to. People who are goal oriented and who have a purpose in life are less likely to be stressed as compared to people who are freedom seekers and who are just taking the life as it goes. So that is what a research shows, and that is what I think would probably make sense to back up that research. So I hope that research and that analogy and explanation of, does having a purpose make sense? Is there any power in purpose? I hope that answers that question. So if you are out there wondering, why do I need a purpose in life? I hope that research makes sense for you. I would recommend, if you don't have a life purpose or if you don't have goals at the moment, I would recommend starting small. So the point here is that the purpose doesn't have to be one grand purpose. It can be a small purpose in life. It can be a small goal that you start off with. I recommend that if you have never had a purpose in your life or never had a goal in your life, then start off by setting one small goal for yourself and see how you feel about that scenario. Compare, you know, do a before and after comparison. How do you feel in that period when you are achieving your goal as compared to how are you feeling before you even set goals for yourself? So that will give you an answer whether you want to lead your life being a purpose advocate or whether you want to be a freedom seeker all your life. So as I said, purpose doesn't have to be a grand purpose that I am here to change humanity. I am here to bring happiness to the world. Start off small with what makes you happy. What is the goal that you can instantly think of at this point? I always emphasize that don't overthink on a lot of scenarios because I think our brain does that trick. The more we think about it, the more lost we are in what the original question was. So give yourself 5-10 minutes after this video, just now, pause it, whatever. But just give yourself 5-10 minutes that what is a goal that I can set for yourself? If I am going to help you set a goal or a purpose in life, you could start off by yourself. There are 7 areas or 8 areas of Wheel of Life. I've spoken about Wheel of Life earlier as well. I'll link the video above. There are 8 areas that you could set your goals in. One, career, if you have one, you could set for that. Maybe, for a certain position, maybe a goal to accomplish a particular task which seems difficult for you at the moment. You can set money goals for yourself, earning X amount in 1 month or 6 months by doing something. You could set goals for your family, how your family and your relationships look like. Set goals for your love life or happiness quotient in your love life. You could set goals for the fun element of it. Like, my goal is to go on this trip, which might not be too far. And maybe you've already taken that trip before. In next 6 months, that could be your goal. Your goal could be around family. Your goal could be around friends. Your goal could be around spirituality. So there are a lot of different areas you could set goals for. If you are someone who doesn't have a goal at the moment, I recommend trying this out. Our life is a trial and error, guys. I think you will only know an answer to something if you jump into it and if you try. If you think, as I said, like, it doesn't have to be a grand one, start small. Pick a 1 week goal, 1 month goal, 6 months goal, whatever suits for you. Pick something that's easy for you. You don't necessarily have to pick which is very difficult for you and you're already scared thinking of it. Don't do that. Pick up something that you think you can easily do. Limit yourself in a time box yourself, and just like, this is my goal for 1 month, this is what I'm going to achieve in 1 month, and then see how you are, how your emotions change by that. See how your thinking change if you are more goal focused as opposed to handling life as it goes. So having a purpose in life, it's directly linked to, as I said, it's very subjective to everybody else. It could be different for everybody else. At the end of the day, if you feel joy and fulfillment and contentment in things that you're doing today, that might be the path that you want to follow. But if you think you are sitting here and cribbing about the life you have, then you should give the other thing a try, I guess. So at the end of the day, what your personal values and belief systems are, because the way we are, way our personality has been shaped, it is all dictated by the childhood experiences that we have had, and it is different for all of us. So based on what your belief system is, your value system is, based on what gives you joy, is your path. So no one else can dictate that for you, right? So I would say, if you are already a goal advocate, great for you. I think I am in that category as well. I am goal oriented, quite goal oriented, and I always want to be that. And for someone who is a freedom seeker, you guys are not wrong. I'm not preaching that you guys are wrong. If you are happy being a freedom seeker all your life, wonderful, then that's meant for you. If you think you are cribbing about your life because things are not working out in your favor, you might want to switch directions for some time and see how life pans out for you. Again, life is meant to be an easy game. You don't need to bombard yourself with so difficult problems in life that you start hating your life. Start off by doing the things that you love doing. Set goals for things that you can easily achieve and achieve them. Goals don't need to be tough. They need to be something that makes you happy. So start small and see how you're feeling. Maybe the chances are you felt more stressed when you had goals in your life, which means that maybe being a freedom seeker is a path that's meant for you. So all in all, I'm going to wrap up the video here. All in all, I think having a life purpose in life is subjective to every individual. It's mandatory? No. It depends on how you are. It depends on what you want out of life. And no answer is right or wrong. So see what works out for you at the end of the day. Find happiness in your life. Do things that make you happy, because that's what we are here on this planet for. I hope this has helped. I hope it resonated with both set of people. I hope both set of people, both goal advocates, purpose advocates, and the freedom seekers are watching this video. Do let me know via comments below on which category you are in. What do you think? What are your thoughts on having a purpose in life? And I would really love to hear it from you, because a lot of times creators who are sitting out there in a room where no one is there are sharing their opinions. It's wonderful to see if other people resonate with us. It's wonderful to see some people having same views or different views on the same topic. It's really great. So I highly encourage you to go down and comment down below. I will see you another week with another interesting topic. All right, see you all next time. Bye bye.